So you're just starting off in Firewall Zero Hour for the PlayStation Virtual Reality headset, and you don't know maybe where you should start or what you should do to get you started on the road of popping headshots and getting all them W's. If so, this guide is for you. Hey there, lads and ladies, this is Petrifying Pumpkins here, and this video is all about a beginner's guide for Firewall Zero Hour, just to help people get into the firewall, to kind of know what it's about, especially considering that Firewall has been added to the instant game collection for PS Plus this month. So without further ado, let's just jump right into it. So my first point would be communication. So Firewall is a team-based 4v4 online shooter, so communication is key, especially considering you only have one life, and if you want to win, you're going to need to be talking to all your teammates. You should be thinking about playing tactically rather than going out guns blazing or being a lone wolf. And the best teams out there do this by constantly communicating with each other. Now, I know some people out there watching may be shy, and they may find the idea of talking to strangers intimidating or whatnot. But you don't need to have a huge conversation and tell people your life story. Simple callouts like enemy to the left, enemy to the right, there's a trap over there, there's, you know, the laptop is open, stuff like that. That would be a huge help for your teammates, and that would greatly enhance your odds of winning a game. And keep in mind, once you do die in Firewall, you get access to all the security cameras all over the map. So this is where communication is vital. You've got the bird's eye view, you can be telling your teammates information that they wouldn't know otherwise, and that could be hugely helpful for your team. Keep in mind as well, every PSVR headset has a microphone built in, so you're good to go. Now this next tip is to start with four, and I understand this is easier said than done, but if you do have some friends who own Firewall Zero Hour and a PSVR headset, or if you just join maybe a Firewall community, maybe on Reddit or the Discord, or you know, just those PlayStation communities that they have built into the PSN, I would recommend that you gather a full squad of four before you even start searching for a match, and there's a couple of reasons for this. Number one, most obvious, most important, is that any online game is better with friends. You're going to have better communication, it's more reliable, and it's just going to be all around more fun in general. My second reason for this is that you're going to have an easier time matchmaking when you got a full squad. It'll go quicker for you, you should encounter less host migration issues, and when you have a full squad, you can be matched up against another full squad, so matchmaking can be rapid when you have the full squad. So I know it's not viable for everyone, but if you can get that full squad, do. Next up, you might be wondering which contractor is best for you for a starter. So Firewall launched with 12 contractors, but since then they've added a whole bunch more with DLC, so it might be a bit overwhelming to figure out which contractor is good for you, considering each contractor has their own unique embedded skill. And I do have a few recommendations for beginners. So my first one would be Okoro. His skill is Heavy Juicy. That allows you to take extra explosive damage. So anything from grenades, mines, C4s, you're going to survive them where other contractors wouldn't. Another good starter contractor would be Texas. Now Texas has the Bullet Sponge ability. Lets her take more damage from bullets, obviously, but it does not have any impact on headshots. So think of it like you're wearing a bulletproof vest. Getting shot in the head is still going to down you as quick as ever. Do keep in mind that every contractor has two skill slots. So that means that while you can have Texas with her Bullet Sponge as her primary one, her embedded one, you can't change that one. The second one, you could put Okoro's Heavy Juicy in there, and all of a sudden you've got resistance to both bullets and explosives, and I think that's a good mix for beginners, because you're going to be kept alive longer, and maybe you're going to get more experience, which might be vital for those early hours when you're starting off playing. Now those are just the two recommendations I would make to beginners, but that's not to say that they're the only contractors you should go for. There's a couple of other good ones too. Raha, her ability is called Scout, and that lets enemies show up on your wrist radar as long as they're within a certain range of you. That's a very useful skill to have. Also, some people find Firewall maybe a little bit slow in terms of the movement speed, so Diaz will be a good choice there. His skill, Double Time, will let you move faster than anyone else who doesn't have that skill. And keep in mind, you can take those skills and put them as the secondary skill for any of the other contractors, so you can mix and match, find what's right for you, and go with that. So those four contractors I would recommend taking a look at, see what works for you, and then as you get more experience, experiment with the newer ones, you know? Next up is your loadout. Now, I always get the questions in my videos, you know, what is the best weapon in the game? What's the best loadout for somebody who's starting off? And before, once upon a time, it was the Taylor CQB assault rifle that was the king in this game. Since then, recently enough, First Contact Entertainment have kind of changed the balance of the guns in this game. So while the Taylor CQB is still very good, still very effective, there's other guns that are viable now too. So it's not just Taylor every time. Having said that, I would still recommend the Taylor CQB for beginners. It unlocks early. It's like a level 6 or level 7 or something like that, so you can get that very quick. A couple, maybe an hour or two of gameplay and you should be able to get that. If you want to try a different assault rifle later on, maybe the Reg Classic that they've added to the game, that's pretty much another hot one that a lot of people are using, especially at close range. It seems to be very effective. Now, I wouldn't worry too much about the attachments, like the muzzle brakes and the hiders and stuff like that. They don't seem to impact the weapons too much. The suppressor maybe more so than others, but you should put on an extended magazine when you unlock it. A laser is no harm, and then a sight, either the red dot sight or the hollow sights, whichever one you want, whatever you prefer. I prefer a red dot sight myself, and a foregrip as well. Next up then, you might be wondering, what about your secondary weapon? Which handgun do you want? And I'm always going to recommend you go for that revive pistol. So even though it's recently been nerfed, so it only carries one revive dart now, revive pistol is still such a useful tool. It's going to save your teammates bacon on so many occasions. It doesn't unlock until level 26, which is going to be quite a few hours of gameplay maybe before you can get that. So until you do get that, I would recommend you just pick whatever handgun you want. You're not really going to be using handguns. Now, they did get buffed in a patch recently enough, but they're still nowhere near as effective as your assault rifle. You're never going to use them unless you kind of have to, unless you're out of ammo or you're stuck in a reload or something like that. It's going to be very rare. Next up then are your lethals, and I would recommend you just experiment with these yourselves. Frag grenades, very easy to understand, everyone kind of knows what they are, but you might prefer impacts, you know, you might prefer stickies. Try them out, see what feels better for you. You know, maybe you want to lay down traps instead with C4 and mines, you know, whatever. You got to see that for yourself. I can't tell you what's best there. The same story applies for your tactical items. You're going to want to experiment with these, but you also want to keep in mind, you know, the map and stuff like that. Some of these items are going to be more effective on certain maps where they wouldn't on others, you know, depending on how exposed they are, how many doors and stuff like that. My next tip is to aim for the head. Go for headshots whenever you can. And this one is kind of obvious, but some people, including me for the longest time, would just go for the chest area, center mass. It's an easier target. You kind of instinctively go there. But I would recommend that you be a little braver and go for that head. I know it's a smaller target. It's more difficult to do, but you will put so much more damage into an enemy. And when you do get that headshot, it makes a sound. Very satisfying, you know. You can practice doing this in the training, solo training modes, stuff like that, so you can get a feel for what it's like to hit enemies in the head. Just go for the head, basically. You know, because in those 50-50 situations where you and the enemy both spot each other at the same time, if you're going for headshots, he's going for chest shots, you're going to win every time. Next tip is dealing with rushers. So rushing in Firewall is a tactic that some squads in Firewall use. So at the beginning of the round, straight away they just sprint to where they think you are, and they will immediately rush in there trying with the idea of catching you with your pants down and just like try and wipe you out straight away. It can be very difficult, especially if you're a defender. You're trying to set up your traps and stuff like that. All of a sudden, they're on you and you didn't really have time to put down any traps. Your pants are down, you're exposed, and you just get nailed. But there is a couple of things you can do to kind of minimize the impact of rushers. So once you know you're dealing with a squad that is rushing consistently, first thing you want to do is stick together with your squad if you can. Obviously, this is where communication is key. Once again, stick together, have each other's backs, be ready to revive. Another thing you can do is to maybe pull back, find yourself a nice little defensive position, get into cover, watch your corners, let the rushers come, let them do all the work. They want to rush, let them do it. And then you got a more of a fair fight then, you know, rather than being unprepared. Now, some people, maybe yourselves included, will think that this Russian tactic takes the fun out of the game, but it is a valid tactic, and First Contact Entertainment have taken steps to kind of neuter the effectiveness of this tactic. It's still a very effective tactic though, so I wouldn't be surprised to see First Contact Entertainment taking even further action to, you know, nerf Russian. My next tip then is to just jump right in. Now, you may be wondering about things like, you know, map knowledge and stuff like that, and that is very important. There's nearly 20 maps in this game. Some people have been playing for over a year, so they've got a big advantage of you in terms of that. But I think the best way to learn these maps and whatnot is to just jump in, play by experience. You could try playing in solo training, and you will learn like spawn locations and stuff like that there. That's a good idea. But the AI in the training isn't going to behave the same way as real players, so you want to play real matches. You're going to see how people react, how they're like the choke points on matches and the lines of sights and stuff like that, that maybe you wouldn't see with AI. So I would recommend you just jump in and learn by experience. My last tip then is to just simply have fun. Now, you can play Firewall in a very serious way. You can be super coordinated, playing for the win every time, stuff like that, and you can have fun doing that, and you will find that in Firewall. And on the other side of the coin, you can just like goof around, mess around, make some friends, have some laughs, and just, you know, kill some people while you're doing this. And definitely that fun is to be had. Like this channel, I've made so many kind of serious videos about Firewall, maybe analyzing weapons and maps and trailers and all that kind of stuff. But if you actually watch any of my streams, you'd see that like 90% of the time I'm just messing around with my teammates. We're just having fun, we're just laughing constantly. Well, not constantly, of course. Sometimes we get serious, sometimes we get salty, but most of the time it's just good fun, you know. And that is it for this video, lads and ladies. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you got some kind of benefit from us, especially if you're a newcomer to Firewall. Before I end this video, let me give a special thank you to my Patreon supporters who are keeping this channel afloat. Their names are on screen right now. Thank you very much for your support. And let me give a particular shout out to my top tier patrons, Tradition, Columbus Thomas III, Pete Hawkins, and Crumb. Thanks to their generosity, this channel can keep growing. If you want to join the Patreon, the link will be in the description below, along with the link to the Discord and, you know, all that kind of stuff, that Twitters and whatnot, if you want to join. But you can help out the old-fashioned way with the likes and the sharing and subscribing and all that kind of stuff as well. I'd appreciate that too. That's it for now. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.